Hello friends, hi, I am Abdul Halim. Today we want to discuss the introduction part of Mazar theory. There are two questions in today's lecture. First question is, what is Mazar? And second is intuitively concept and a definition of Mazar theory. First, let us consider, let X be a non-empty set. This is X and this is a subset of X. This is called Y. This is a subset of X and this is the set X. Then mu of Y is equal to size of Y. Mu is a measure. Technically, it's a function. Measure. Measure of Y is equal to size of Y. And in R square, suppose in have discussed R square, this is a rectangle and one side is A and another side is B and the set is called A. Then the measure of A is a very easy that A dot B and another figure circle C is the radius and the set is defined by C. Then the measure of C is equal to pi C square. This is a small c, this is capital C. Okay, when A, B are two different, then measure of A union B is equal to measure of A plus measure of B. This is obviously clear and measure of phi is equal to 0 or in such case A intersection B is equal to phi, measure of A intersection B is equal to 0. This is intuitively our concept in Mazar theory. What is Mazar? This is a picture of sets and each of subsets are inside in it. Then each subset assign a positive number including 0 informally. A measure has the property of being monotone in the sense that if A is a subset of B, the measure of A is less than or equal to the measure of B. Furthermore, the measure of the length of the empty set is required to 0. That I want to say, A subset of B, then the measure of A less or equal to measure of B. In mathematical analysis, a measure on a set is a systematic way to assign a number to each suitable subsets of the set, intuitively interpreted as the size. In the sense, a measure is a generalization of the length, area and volume. A particularly important example is Lebesgue measure in Euclidean space, which assign the conventional length, area and volume of Euclidean geometry to suitable subset of n-dimensional Euclidean space Rn. For instance, the Lebesgue measure of the interval of 0, 1, obviously 1. Technically, a measure is a function. Definitions of measure. Okay. Let x be a non-empty set and x comma sigma be a measurable space. If function mu sigma 2 positive r including 0 union infinity such that number 1 mu of phi is equal to obviously 0 in our intuitive concept. Second, mu of I is equal to 1 to infinity AI is equal to I equal to 1 to infinity mu of AI I equal to 1 to infinity for every AI belongs to sigma such that AI intersection AJ is equal to phi for each I not is equal to j is called a measure on x comma sigma. The triple or x comma sigma comma mu is called a measure space. Okay, is called a measure space. And sigma subset of power set of x. And additively mu of E, this is E, mu of E obviously greater equal to 0. Okay. And each AI is called measurable. And there is another results in the topics of real analysis. We know that will be more helpful to use a measure. This is any open set in R can be represented as a countable union of open intervals. And the second one, the sigma algebra of all Borel set in R is generated by the collection of all open intervals or the collection of all intervals with rational endpoints. These two results will be helpful to discuss much more things in measure theory. This is the definition, but we have not discussed what is sigma algebra. It is very necessary to discuss the sigma algebra and Borel set. In next video, it will come.